Good day, everybody. In this module 5 of 18 CV 42, the second topic is cable. Now these cables are used in suspension bridges. You might have seen suspension bridges, or you might have used suspension bridges. While using the suspension bridges, on either side you will find a cable like this. Okay, that we are going to discuss or analyze in this topic. Suspension bridges are used for roadways if the span is more than 200 meter, and if it is difficult to have intermediate structure, intermediate supports, that means what we call piers. In such conditions, these suspension bridges are designed to pass this obstruction. As I told, if you have seen or if you have used the suspension bridges, on either side this bridge will be consisting of two cables, and usually with suspenders like this, which supports the roadway. This is the longitudinal section. If you see cross section, this will be the roadway, and these are the suspenders, and this is the typical suspension bridge. Now the different parts that bridge consisting of, it is the cable mainly, and this cable are supported with suspenders, and this is the roadway, and this cable is passed over a support, and these two, this is one and this is called tars. And the distance between these two tars is called the span, or span of the cable. And this cable is passed over this tar, and it is fixed to the ground level, to the ground or to the concrete mass, or it is also called dead band. And that cable on the other side of the tar is called anchored cable. It is anchored. You can see in the electric poles also, wherein for the stability of that electric pole, one extra wire will be anchored to the ground, and that is called anchor cable on both the sides. Okay, these are the parts of a suspension bridge where cables are used to support the roadway. Now for the roadway, the best example, it is in tin factory in Bangalore. Tin factory, that is a suspension bridge. Or in Calcutta, Howrah suspension bridge. Or if you see some foot path or footway suspension bridges, which are in the coastal area, are Western Ghats, that is in Markira. If you have seen Abbey Falls, there is a small suspension bridge. Or near Sulya, that is after Markira, on the way to Mangalore, one hanging bridge was designed. And this is for your information. Around 1998, the longest suspension bridge, footbridge, was across Ghataprabha near Ghataprabha River, and it was designed by a team of civil engineering department of KVG College of Engineering, Sulya. And when I was heading the department, and we as experts, we have visited the site also after the design and for the clarification of this anchoring, because this has to be done carefully. Otherwise, the main support is this and tower. If these are not designed properly, cable will not withstand the load. And we went personally to supervise the anchoring of the cable, because in that area the soil was black cotton and it was not strong enough to withstand. Therefore, the executive engineer in charge of this was called us to supervise the ongoing process of the construction of this, that is hanging bridges and their parts. Now, coming to the first, we have to analyze this cable which is supporting the suspender, because the load will be transferred to the cable, that is the load which is acting on the roadway will be transferred to the cable through suspenders. And the second part is the analysis of the anchor cable. Mainly this main cable design or analysis and the anchor cable analysis, it consisting of mainly two parts. First, let us come to the analysis of cable. Since there are number of suspenders and they are very large in suspension bridges, the load on the cable may be taken as UDL. That is first this thing. That is, these cables numbers are very large. Therefore, the load which is acting on the roadway will be transferred to the cable as a downward load, as in the form of UDL. Number of point loads placed together, nothing but UDL, uniformly distributed load. And cables are very flexible. Cables are very flexible and they do not resist any bending moment, nothing but flexion. And they adjust their shape to loads and resist the load only by tension. You can see, if you have used the footpath suspension bridges, if you go to the center, we find we are unbalanced. Because of the bending moment, the cable will adjust its shape in such a way that are to resist this load by tension only. Because as it is a flexible, there will not be any bending moment from one support to the another support. Bending moment will be zero at every point in the cable. This cable will adjust its shape to withstand the loads depending upon the position. Now coming to the, therefore, let us see how to analyze a cable if it is subjected to UDL. Now consider a cable of length, horizontal length, that is nothing but span, L, be supported at points A and B, which are at horizontal distance, that L, span, and are at the same level as shown in figure. A and B are at same level, let us see. Now, the cable is subjected to UDL of intensity, let W per unit length. Now, because of this, let the central deflection is H. Now, this is the consideration in the cable. Now, because of this load will be transferred to the cable, then this cable will transfer the load to the support. Therefore, let VA and HA are the vertical and horizontal reaction at support A. VA, VB and HB are the vertical and horizontal reactions at the support B. It is almost similar to the arches. Arches are reversed. Support reactions, everything will be same. But only point is, in arches there will be bending moment. But most of the load will be transferred through axial compression. But here, everything will be transferred through the tension in the cable. Therefore, that cable size should be designed to withstand the maximum tension. There is no bending moment here. Now, these are the consideration. Now, it is subjected to UDL throughout, no doubt. This vertical downward UDL is distributed to the support A and B equally, that is VA will be equal to VB, and that will be equal to total load. It is intensity of UDL, intensity of UDL, that is W, into L, the length over which it is distributed, and it is transferred to the supports equally, means by 2. There is no need to go for equilibrium conditions like arches. Directly VA is equal to VB, we can write total load divided by 2, total load is WL and by 2. Or by equilibrium conditions also, as like arches it can be formed. Now, to find the horizontal reactions, in case of arch, hinged arch, what we were doing, this was a reverse. Like this, we are taking the algebraic sum of the moment about the cronage, but because any moment was moment, algebraic sum of the moment will be zero because this is an inch. But in case of cable, it is a reverse. You see here, we know because of this flexibility of the cable, bending moment will be zero at every point. Therefore, for simple thing, let us take the moment about this point and equate it to zero. Means sigma MC is equal to zero about the central point, because bending moment is zero here. Everywhere it is zero, but it will be easy for calculation if you take about this point. Now here, HA, HB, VB, HB, HA, HB, this is VB, This is BA. It is the reverse. Now, the load acting will be like this. Whatever the load, that is W per meter, that is VA and VB are equal. That is VA is equal to VB is equal to total load divided by 2. That is W into length over which it is distributed by 2 is the VA and VB. Now to find HA and HB, we should take about this point. Now this is the previous topic. Arch, I'll remove it. Now, to find HA, as usual, if you apply sigma, Fx is equal to 0, HA is equal to HB, that is equal to HA. Now, if you take moment about the sigma MC here, if you take this as C, this point, sigma MC is equal to 0, you can consider left side or you can consider right side also. Now, if you consider left side of this buttermost point, about here, it is here analysis, sigma MC left side is equal to 0, minus H into H, about this point, HA creates a moment like this. Is it done? Like this. It is anticlockwise. That is minus H. The line of action of HA or H is here. Therefore, perpendicular distance to the line of action is this small h. Shortest distance to the line of action of HA. That is moment definition. That is small h is the perpendicular distance. Then that is minus capital H into small h. Then VA, this VA, it is about C I am taking. It is acting like this, causing a moment like this. It is clockwise, that is plus VA into its perpendicular distance is L by 2, because this distance, half distance, this is the distance. VA line of action is here. It is the perpendicular distance, that is VA into L by 2. Then UDL is acting down. About C, it is acting down, means creating this type of moment. That is minus. Up to C, only this portion of the UDL, that is half portion of the UDL, is responsible for the bending moment. Therefore, it is minus W into L by 2, only half, into its perpendicular distance is L by 4, because this UDL, it is for a length of L by 2 I am considering, because up to Z, this is equal to an imaginary point load of magnitude W into L by 2, into its perpendicular distance will be It is acting at a midpoint. Mid length means this is L by 4 and this is L by 4. That means half of L by 2. Got it? That is UDL. No, therefore, no other force equal to 0. Therefore, from this, capital H can be calculated, that is, it is here. Okay, anti-clockwise moment, clockwise moment due to VA, that is WL by 2, it is here, and minus because of this half length UDL about this center point is equal to 0. If you simplify this, the horizontal reaction H will be equal to WL squared by 8H, that is the finding of the support reaction over VAVB over and horizontal reaction is over. Same equilibrium condition, because of symmetrical loading, just directly it is written. All sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0, sigma ma or sigma mb is equal to 0 by considering all the forces acting on the cable, and sigma about this buttermost point is equal to 0 by considering in arch only difference is it will be called as crown hinge. Now here it is the buttermost point. By applying same equilibrium condition or by simplifying by symmetry writing this thing, we can find support reactions. That is finding the support reaction. Now to find the tension, if you consider any section XX, if considering any section at a distance XX, at this XX let the unbalanced force R, if you try to write the free body diagram of the left side of this section XX, external forces HA and VA will be there, and UDL will be there here for a length of X, and let the unbalanced force is H and unbalanced vertical force is V at any section, and let T is the tension in the cable, it is along the tangent to this point, that is T. Now V is the shear at any section. This V can be calculated by applying equilibrium condition sigma Fy is equal to 0. We'll see that later in numerical problem. If this is the unbalanced force, that's all. Now if V is the shear at any section XX or unbalanced vertical force, then tension in the cable T can be calculated as H squared plus V squared under square root. H squared plus V squared under square root at any section. And inclination of this T at this point can be calculated as tan inverse of V by H. That is simple analysis as like arch. That is T at any point, T can be calculated using this equation. V is the unbalanced vertical force and T is the unbalanced horizontal force. Now T is maximum at the support because H remains same everywhere, but V will be different. V at any section will be changing. Here V will be VA minus this UDL. Definitely this will be less than VA. If you go away from this further, again this VA, this V will be this VA minus this W into X. If X increases, V decreases. Therefore, maximum vertical reaction will be at the support. That is, VA will be maximum. At the other point, it will be VA minus this UDL for the length for which it is considered. Therefore, VA is maximum at the support. Our vertical force is maximum at the support. And HA, everywhere it will be same. Because here H will be sigma fx is equal to 0, means this H will be equal to HA. Any point or at any section, horizontal unbalanced force will be equal to HA. But VA will be difference, and VA is maximum at the support. Therefore, this T will be maximum at the support here. Therefore, T is maximum at support because V is maximum. There is nothing but VA. Therefore, T max will be equal to V max plus HA or HB because both are same under square root. Resultant reaction is nothing but tension. There we call as resultant reaction, but here that is normal thrust we call. Here it is T maximum. Almost this and arch analysis are similar. They are reversed. HA, HB, V is maximum at support. Then when T is minimum, if T is maximum means T will be minimum at particular point. Now T is minimum at this point, that is here, at the bottommost point. Why? Because, you see, if you take an arch, if you take a cable, T is maximum here, that is T maximum. Because if you want this point T, means this will be like this. This is T at any point. Now, if you go on writing like that, at the bottommost point, T will become horizontal. Nothing but, if you draw free body diagram, T is nothing but H. Right? Because here HA, VA. Here, unbalanced vertical force will be zero if you draw the free body diagram of this. Here, it will become zero because here, V will be zero. Only H will be there. That is nothing but T because H will be there like this. Therefore, T will be equal to H. And tensile force in the cable is minimum. At the tension, at the center, that is T minimum, will be vertical reaction will be zero, vertical unbalanced force at the center will be zero, plus HA or HB whole squared means T minimum is nothing but H. That means V at center is zero. Now, other few points that we have to remember to solve numerical problem. That's all the analysis. Other few more points that we require in the analysis are, the shape of the cable is parabola. The equation of the parabola, we know, y is equal to 4hx l minus x by l squared. x and y are the coordinates at any point, h is the maximum dip, and l is the span length. Okay, this equation we know in the arches, we have to remember. Then length of the cable, nothing but this capital L. Yeah, the length of the cable, this is small L, this capital L, actual length of the cable will be more than the span. That sometimes it is required, because sometimes span will be given, sometimes length of the cable will be given. You should be very careful in reading the question. Length of the cable, L will be equal to small l plus 8h squared divided by 3l. Now, considering the left side of xx, this, because the cable is in equilibrium, means the portion of the cable up to this xx is also in equilibrium. Therefore, if you apply sigma fx is equal to 0 here, sigma fx is equal to 0, it will be t cos theta is equal to h. T cos theta is equal to h. T cos theta is nothing but h. Actually, we are finding h as, sorry, t tension in the cable as h square plus v square. But if you want h, this can be resolved. T cos theta is nothing but h for this equilibrium, this point. Or t sin theta will be equal to v. T sin theta will be equal to V. Sorry, T sin theta will be equal to V. I'll come to that. T cos theta is equal to H. If you apply sigma Fy is equal to 0 for this point, this will be T sin theta will be equal to Va minus Wx. Va, that is Va minus Wx, that is the unbalanced force, because that is required to find theta. From this, theta can be found, because at any point inclination of the cable is required. These few more points: equation of the parabola, actual length of the cable, not the span. Span is the horizontal distance, whereas L, capital, is the length of the cable. It will be more than the span. And to find theta, these two conditions, t cos theta is equal to h and t sin theta will be Va minus Wx. From this, theta can be found. Now that is the analysis of the cable. Do you understand? Just by applying equilibrium conditions, we can find Va, Vb or by symmetry, and Ha, Hb by applying the algebraic moment condition about the bottommost point. Then tension in the cable, that is the main analysis or design here. Tension in the cable is maximum at the support, because Va is maximum at the support, and it will be equal to Va squared plus Ha squared under square root. T will be minimum at the lowest or bottommost point, because vertical force, unbalanced force, will be 0 here. Therefore, T will be equal to simply H. That's all. This two important points. Then these are some formula we have to remember. Equation of the parabola, actual length of the cable, and to find theta, this by equilibrium, T cos theta is equal to H, T sin theta is equal to Va minus W into X. That is the analysis of cables subjected to UDL. Now, another point is, now we understood the analysis of the main cable it is called, between the two towers or between the two supports. Now cable consisting of this main suspension bridges consisting of main cable and anchor cable. Because if you analyze just the cable, it is not sufficient. This side also it is important, because it has to be anchored properly, otherwise it will not stay back. Therefore, let us see the analysis of anchor cable. Now this is the main cable, this is the anchor cable. Now anchor cable, if you have observed as a civil engineer, when you are using this suspension bridges, this main cable is passed over the tower with two types of supports. One is guided pulley support. It is just like a pulley in a well to lift the water. This main cable is passed over this pulley, and this was taken to the ground level and it is anchored. It is ground level. And this should be anchored to the ground in such a way that it should withstand the force here. Otherwise, it should not come out of that anchoring. Usually, this will be anchored to a big concrete mass, and it is called dead man. Let the inclination of the cable which is making main cable is theta, and let this anchored cable is anchored to the mass, concrete mass, or to the earth at an angle alpha. Now if you assume the pulley as frictionless, the tension in the main cable is equal to tension in the anchor cable. I think that you might have seen some numerical problems in elements of civil engineering in the friction topic. That is, if the pulley is frictionless, the force in the cable on either side will be same. Now assuming frictionless pulley, team tension in the cable will be equal to tension in the anchor cable. Therefore, this mass should be designed to withstand this tension, nothing but this main cable tension. Now we will see how the analysis of this. Now because of this pulley, force on either side will be same. Therefore, both the sides they are pulling like this, there will be vertical force transferred to the tower. This tower should also be designed properly. Now, vertical load transferred to the tower. This. Will be equal to this T. If you analyze T sin theta, T we know that we have seen analysis. T will be VA square plus HA square at the support point. That is the maximum. VA and HA we know, therefore T we know. And the force acting on the star will be T, if you resolve this, T cos theta, sorry, T sin theta away from the angle theta. And this, as I told, it is a frictionless pulley, the force on either side will be zero, it will be same. Therefore, this is also T, and it will be T sin alpha. Vertical force on the tower will be T sin theta and plus T cos theta. This is tower, T O W E R. d sin theta plus t sin theta plus t sin alpha. Or if you take common factor t, it is sin theta plus sin alpha. It is simple from the figure, just a resolution. Now, just T O W E R. Now that is the vertical load transfer to the torque, T sin theta and T sin alpha. Then horizontal load transported to the torque, because this horizontal component and this is horizontal component will be there, and that will be T cos theta, this T cos theta minus T sin theta, sorry, T cos alpha. T cos theta, this if you resolve, and this if you resolve T cos alpha, that is the difference. T cos theta minus T cos alpha, or T is equal to cos theta minus cos alpha. Therefore, TAR should be designed for a vertical load of this and for a horizontal load of this one. Now, to design a vertical for a design to design the star for a vertical force, nothing but compression, simple. Now, because of this unbalanced force on this, there will be some bending moment. It is act like a cantilever beam, vertical cantilever. That unbalanced force, this one, and this height of the tar will be the bending moment. For that, this bending moment, it should be designed. That is, here it will be like this. Tar. Unbalanced force will be acting here. That is T cos theta minus T cos alpha. That unbalanced, this will be the height of the tower. Therefore, here bending moment will be this unbalanced force into this. This bending moment, it should be designed. That is T, this one. That is horizontal force on the tower. It is nothing but this into height of the tower. This one. If H is the height of the tower, H1 it is taken. Okay. It can be calculated, bending moment. That is the analysis of anchor cable and the tar. If cable is passed over a frictionless pulley, that is one type of support. Now, another type is roller support. It is also called, this is called saddle. It is supported on a roller, and this main cable will be fixed, connected here, and it will go like this. That is anchor cable. Again, it is grounded, anchored to the ground. Here, the main cable and the anchor cables are connected to the saddle. Hence, two cables need not to have same tension. They will be different. maybe in some cases. Now to analyze this, if you apply sigma fx is equal to 0, because this roller support means it should not move horizontally. Therefore, sigma fx is equal to 0 saddle roller. If you apply this, T anchor cable, that is TA cos theta, TA TA cos theta, that is T anchor, TA, this is okay, previous is only correct. TA cos alpha, and this will be TS cos theta. That is sigma fx is equal to 0 means this TA cos alpha and TS cos theta. Therefore, TA can be calculated, tension in the anchor cable as TS cos theta, TS cos theta divided by cos alpha. That is, just by applying equilibrium condition. Therefore, if you want to calculate vertical force here, it is the sum, this TA sine alpha. If you resolve this vertically, it is acting on the tower away from alpha. Therefore, TA sine alpha, and this will be TS main cable, TS sine theta. Now, bending moment on the tower is 0, because here unbalanced force will be 0. Therefore, tower should be designed only for the axial compression. In the previous case, this was designed like a cantilever, vertical cantilever, for maximum bending moment here also and for vertical compression also. But here it is just designed to withstand only vertical force, because bending moment is 0. This is the analysis of roller support. Therefore, that is the theory in this. To conclude, cables are used in suspension bridges. Suspension bridges are used for roadways. If the span is more and difficult to have intermediate supports. Now, suspension bridges consisting of two cables on either side. In the cross section, you can see this is one cable running perpendicular, and here is another cable. This is in the elevation, and different parts cable. This is the main cable, and this is anchor cable. This is also anchor cable. This is the tower on which it is supported, and these are the suspenders. Because suspenders are placed very near, the load which is acting on the road will be transferred to the cable as uniformly distributed load. That is cable. Now coming to the analysis of the cable. Since number of suspender, it is taken as UDL, and cable is flexible, therefore it will not resist any bending moment. It will resist the load just by adjusting the shapes of the cable itself, and resistance can be, it will be, the load will be taken by the cable as a tension. Now cable subjected to UDL throughout same HAVA, HBVB, and VA is equal to VB and WL by 2. By applying sigma MC is equal to 0 here, the buttermost point, by considering left hand side, this equilibrium condition H can be formed. Now if V is the shear at any section here, V, and H is the horizontal imbalance before, at any section, T can be calculated as H squared plus V squared under square root. Remember, this T is maximum at the support, because V is maximum at the support compared to any other point. And this T will be minimum at the bottommost point, because unbalanced vertical force here will be zero. Therefore, T will be only, it is H, unbalanced H. H is nothing but HAR, HB. That is what it is here. Then few points you have to remember. Y is equal to equation of the parabola and length, actual length of the cable. Then by considering left of XT, cos theta is equal to H, and T sin theta will be equal to V. That is unbalanced force. That is nothing but VA minus this UDL acting downward. From this, theta can be calculated. That is analysis of the cable. Now coming to the analysis of the anchor cable. As I told, this is anchor cable. Anchor cable can be passed over a pulley support like this. If it is passed over a pulley, if we assume pulley is frictionless, the force on the cable, main cable, and force in the anchor cable will be same. Let it is TT. Now because of this T, if inclination of this cable is theta, and this, if we take some angle alpha, anchor cable, the vertical force will be T sin theta plus T sin alpha, and unbalanced force here will be T cos theta minus T cos alpha. Therefore, this will act as a vertical cantilever subjected to a proper point load at the end, free end. Therefore, there will be bending moment at the fixed end here, and that bending moment can be calculated using the unbalanced horizontal force here into height of the tar. Now if the main cable and anchor cable are connected to saddle support, saddle is placed on the roller. Roller, if there is no movement, therefore horizontal force should be zero. Therefore, this will be T cos alpha is equal to T sin theta, cos theta. From that, the tension in the anchor cable can be formed. In the previous case, tension will be same as that of main cable. Here it is different. By applying equilibrium of the roller, sigma fx is equal to zero, tension in the anchor cable will be formed. And vertical force acting will be this T of the main cable into sin theta, and T the anchor cable into sin alpha will be the vertical load, and no bending moment on the tar. Now this is the brief introduction to the cables. Now we will take some numerical problem in the next class.